Kapresaya Bhutale
Thank you. So many problems are there. But it's supposed to be that somehow one adjusts and be satisfied in the grihastha ashram, one might avoid illicit sex and avoid outside of marriage. Within Grihasala, there's a Madhu Samhita, so there's times when one can have a relation, one shouldn't have. Like on Ekadasi, Janmashtami, holy days, one shouldn't have relations. I don't know why, but it says Ashtami. It's a day like no sex day. So having relations on those days would also be illicit sex. It would be offensive to the holy days and things like that. People have relations, they have children, then it's a devotional service. I was reading an article. I don't call them warlords, they call them some kind of like village chief in Turkey. He He has five wives, one legal and four illegal. He was saying that it was when he was young, it was a status symbol to have more wives. And since Islam allowed it, he did it, although in Turkey it was illegal. They, in 1926, they said people should just have one wife. Or in other Arab countries, they're allowed four. Some of you got five. You have to give each one a separate house according to the rules. So you have five houses. And the house had to be far enough away that they had all kinds of like all the rules. But then he was looking back and said, if I had it all to do over again, I think I'd just stick with one. A million tables. You have 55 kids in this. At least, I mean, of course, according to the Islamic rules, they're all married. So whether here Prabhupada is promoting monogamy. Have one wife. Make life simple. Chant Hare Krishna. No matter how many partners one has, one doesn't ever get satisfied. Materially, there's no satisfaction. One other offense this Brahmana committed is he had a good wife. Think of all the trauma he caused her, leaving her he had a good wife, probably had children. He never married a prostitute. Just an illicit relation. Recently I was traveling and then some aspiring disciples, they wanted to get initiated, but they're living together in Argentina for 9 years. They never got married. They said in Argentina people don't get married anymore. They don't bother. Why? Old fashioned. I was a bit surprised coming to other than India, you know, I'm used to marriage. I said, well, in this family we get married. It's part of our procedure. So they have made a law that if you live together more than 4 years and you die, your partner gets the inheritance. It's the only people that they're not considered married, but they get an inheritance. Right. So Prabhupada, when he came to the West and he introduced that people should get married, it was like a big thing, something new. So many of the young people, it takes so long, they don't get married. But that's why Prabhupada, when he was a sannyasi, he was personally overseeing marriage ceremonies, and normally sannyasis don't do that. But it was because people just live together and then get married. So the Prabhupada was. People don't understand. Krishna Kanta were actually trying to promote the importance of marriage. People should try to make their family life work. Tendency is people don't take it very seriously. That's very Prabhupada was very frustrated. First of all, he thought to get people sannyas, and after he didn't take it. And he tried to get people married, and then that they weren't taking it serious. Sometimes he'd sit with his hand on his head. What to do? How to spread a worldwide Krishna conscious movement where people don't take it serious? Maybe one person takes it serious, but the other one doesn't. So the Prabhupada had to adjust things a little bit. So to get married legally before the fire sacrifice, so at least we'll do that level of marriage. Because if we don't get fire sacrifice, and then they don't keep it up, some more grain, make them offense. So I don't know, I'm picking up that in the whole, how serious it was considered that Achanil neglected his family vows. This particular verse 65, it's saying he had a good wife, he was from a good family, she neglected him, went for a prostitute instead. You take the vows to be with husband and wife together, they should try to fulfill those vows. So Achanil did it, and then he was considered here Aga Ayu, a life full of sins, asuchi, unclean, malat, impure. Ati garhita, very much condemned. Swaira chari, acting irresponsibly. Ulangya, transgressing the laws of Shastra. Krita kilvisham, regularly committing sinful activities. So they are just considering all that. What they didn't consider is that somehow he was chanting the name of Narayana. That's how he got purified. I mean, because they didn't know that, that was their mistake. There was something they should have known. That's why the Vishnudutas were unhappy with the Yamadutas. You're saying so many things, but you don't. You're saying it's all right, but what about the fact that he chanted the name of Narayana? We're only here because of that. Vishnudutas don't go for ordinary people. Somebody gave a $100,000 or $100 million donation to the hospital. That doesn't atone for all the cows that killed. They have to. Karma goes in two separate accounts, good karma account, bad karma account. So all the bad karma they do, if they do atonement, they do some kind of austerities, they read a chapter of Bhagavad Gita or something, then they get purified for some sins. Then some people just do normal karma, kanda, atonement, fast, and some days. devotional services have tremendous atoning. They are only considering here the material atonement. There's a chandrayana. Every day of the month we eat one more grain of rice. So on full moon you can eat 15 grains and go back down to zero. Not too much rice. Cheesecakes probably you're buying 15 cheesecakes, 14, 13. But grains of rice, not much. Now it's like, this was one guy, he like stuck out like a sore thumb. Now it's just like, you have Ajahnil Club. We were in Bangkok and we had to go downtown to buy our airline ticket. We went in the morning, so it was all closed up. They told us, these in the nighttime, you don't want to come to this part of town. It's a sinful place. One street, heterosex, next street, homosex, next street, transvestites. So, simple activities going on all over the place. What this hell is. I mean, some people don't believe in hell. Hell is, you go to hell after you're dead. So you're in your subtle body. So it's like experiencing a dream while you're awake. And give you other subtle bodies that they torture. When you're tortured when you're alive, if you can die, maybe you can be freed from the torture, but here you're already dead. So it says in the verse here that punishment by Yamaraj is a process of purification for the most abominable sinful persons. Not everyone gets to go to hell. It's a special privilege. You have to be an abominable, sinful person. And then that means you get so much bad karma accumulated that just taking birth and working it out will be a heavy overload. So instead, it lets you burn it off fast. Intensely. Purification. Taking birth and when I'm not taking birth, you're not taking birth, you're just transferred to the hellish regions and then you're given some subtle body, nice subtle body and drop from the mountaintop on sharp rocks. Your body, your sub this dream type body breaks up into little pieces and take it back up to the top and do it all over again 108 times or so, or whatever. Put you in a burning state. Because how can you survive? You can't survive this kind of punishment. This is... But because you identify with the body, even the subtle bodies, it's like you're living through a nightmare. Prabhupada said that sometimes the spiritual master, he has to take the sins of his, burn off the sins of his disciples in nightmares. One day we came to his room and he said that he had a nightmare the night before. But it's like you're awake in the nightmare. So when you wake up and still remember the hellish experiences. So that sometimes the guru, my disciples, committing sinful activities, he has to also suffer. I, some occasion I had to experience something like that, but I don't know if it's for that reason. That's just for night, you wake up. These people stay there for a while. There's 26 standard hellish areas they have. Sometimes you read that some of them were so sinful that they were creating a custom made one. Industrial designers. Designing new and unique health for especially abominable people. New application for engineering. Space available. So they got this Vishnu Dutas, they're just the front end. They're the face of the Yamadutas in this section, they're requesting the Vishnu Dutas, don't obstruct us, this guy deserves everything we're gonna give him. He's a bad guy. He did all these nasty things. He had this relationship with a prostitute who made some money cheating a few people once in a while, and he deserted his wife. Didn't say whether they paid her alimony or not. How many people fit that bill nowadays? Did kill him? Didn't say he killed him yet. They must be in overload mode of Yama-load. That's when we take the Rathyatra card. Always this thinking, you know, it's all the people driving by, hey, that's interesting. Going out to Toronto, that's a few many years ago, I was in Toronto, this lady came. I said, so wonderful what you're doing. So wonderful, this is so beautiful. I'm just thinking, wow, she's giving so many blessings, so much karma is being cleared off just by her appreciation of joining them. And I told her, why don't you go pull the rope? So I asked Krishna, so, oh, I just came from the grocery, I'm not a vegetarian, I have meat in my vein. So maybe I'm not pure, I'm not clean to pull the rope. So we'll leave your bag over there before I can come back. She left her bag like some fence and go over and pull her open and think that. It must be that. Did a lot of white out. You got to look for this rough catcher. How are you now? You're hard now? Tuesdays?
Yeah.
All the people that hear the holy name just by hearing it, they get blessings. Give them prasad. didn't have any done in the French Quarter sometimes. So many people danced with us. We went by one flower seller and took a handful of roses and threw it at the feet of the Lord. Then from the other side came a Christian Harian group or whatever, marching group, and they had a big placard, "Turn or Burn." That was there actually also correct. People don't turn from their sinful activities. They're going to suffer. It's just that we have a different marketing approach. We're offering people a positive alternative.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.